Good morning, student. In the last class, we have taken 3.3 exercise. Up to 6th problem we have completed. Let us go for the 7th problem. What is given there in the 7th problem? They are given one figure, H O P E, and the one side H O line is produced to. I have given one name Q, one point reference point. They are given angle P O Q equal to 70 degree exterior angle, and they are asking to find X is what, Y is what, Z is what. First step I am taking 70 degree. This POQ is given, so it is forming a linear pair here. So I can find HOP angle. So I am taking POQ plus POH equal to 180 degree. So 70 plus POH equal to 180 degree. Therefore POH equal to 180 minus 70, 110 degree. So it is forming a linear pair. So POH angle equal to 180, 110 degree. Then X and Y Z we have to find out. We have found this one angle 110. Now in the parallelogram HOP, angle POH will be equal to HEP. HEP. Why? Because in a parallelogram, opposite angles are equal. So POH equal to HEP. Therefore HEP is already we have found POH is 110. So HEP also 110. That is X degree. So X value is 110. Once again, you go for the triangle HEP. In triangle HEP, angle EHP plus of HEP plus of EBH will be equal to 180 degree because it is a triangle. Two angle we know, 40 and 110 we know. What will be the other angle? Shift this one that side. So 180 minus of 150, you will get EBH value equal to 30 degree. 30 degree you will get. Then EPH is what? EPH, that is 30 degree. So X we know, 40 already given, and then EPH angle also we know. Then what about the Y and Z angle? You see, in a parallelogram, parallelogram means opposite sides are parallel and equal, and one transversal HP is there. So I can take this angle to EHP and HPO. Both are equal because alternative angle. So we know already EHP is 40 degree. So what will be the HPO? That will be also 40 degree. That means Y angle equal to 40 degree. Similarly, the other side EPH, EPH, this is one easier shape, alternative angle. EPH will be equal to PHO, that is equal to 30 degree. How? EPH and PHO, Z shape, alternating angle, so Z equal to 30 degree. So X is 110, Y is 40, and Z is 30. That is your 7th question. Then 8th question, what is given? They are telling GUN, G-U-N, and R-U-N, both are parallelogram. In parallelogram, what is the condition? Opposite sides are parallel and equal, and the diagonal will be bisecting each other. Here they are given GU equal to 3y minus 1, UN equal to 18, NS equal to 26, and then GS equal to 3x. So we have to find the x and y value. We know in a parallelogram opposite side GU and NS are equal. So I am equating GU equal to NS. And what is GU value? They are given 3y minus of 1. That is equal to 26. Shifting 1 here, it will become 27. So 3y equal to 27. Therefore, y equal to 9. And once again, you see here GS and UN are equal because parallelogram opposite sides are equal and parallel. So 3x equal to 18 directly. GS equal to UN, 3x equal to 18. So x equal to what? Cross multiply and divide. 18 upon 3, 6. So x is 6, y is 9. That is first problem, 8th question. Second problem also, you see another parallelogram R, U, N, S is given. And they are given the diagonal length. Suppose I am taking this point as O. R, O given as 16. O, N given as X plus Y. O, S given as 20. And O, U given as Y plus 7. We know in a diagonal, in a parallelogram, diagonal bisect each other, then divide into two equal parts. That means what? R, O equal to O, N. And OU equal to OS. Okay? This same method I am applying here. OU equal to OS. OU is what? Y plus 7. And that is OS is what? 20. Then I am shifting this one. you are getting 20 minus of 7, y value is 13. And another equation is there, on equal to or. Then I am repeating this equation, 16 equal to x plus y. Already y value we know, I am substituting here. So 16 is 13 will come this side, minus 13, therefore x equal to 3. So therefore the value of x and y is 3 and y is 13. 9th question you take it as a homework, similar to 8th question. And 10th question, they are given K, L, M, N. One picture, one letter they are given. And they are given K, L, M 80 degree and L, M 100 degree. They are telling whether it is a trapezium. If it is a trapezium, which sides are parallel? So I am internal angle, I am seeing. See, 80 and 100 are interior angle. Interior angle. So I am adding this interior angle. It is coming to be 180. If the in between two lines, if the angle interior angle is 180 degrees, that KL and M should be what? Parallel to each other. So therefore KL is parallel to M and 9. So inner quadrant KLM is a trapezium because KL and M are parallel since interior angle sum equal to 180 degree. Therefore, a pair of side is parallel. So KLM is a trapezium. Okay. So which side is parallel? KL and M are parallel. That is 10th question. 11th question, same thing they are asking. One diagram they are given. A, B, C, D, trapezium is there. One angle is 120 they are given. What is the angle of C they are asking? And in the figure itself, AB is parallel to CD and BC is a transversal. This is parallel means this is transversal in parallel line you are studying. So interior angle, one angle is 120. What will be the other? We know ABC plus BCD equal to 180 degree because sum of in between the parallel line, sum of two angles equal to 180 degree. So BCD equal to 180 minus of 20. So BCD equal to 60 degree. So BCD is 60 degree. Once again, in the 12th question also they are asking, what figure is given? PQRS and R is 90 degree, Q is 130 degree. What is the angle of P and S they are asking? See, I written here. PQRS is a trapezium because PS and QR are parallel and R angle is 90 degree. Therefore, interior angle other side will be also 90 degree. S angle will be 90 degree. And P plus Q is interior angle. QR and PS are parallel. P and Q are interior angle. One angle is 130. What will be the other angle? P plus Q equal to 180 degree. So P is 180 minus of 30. So angle P equal to 50 degree. So up to this one, this 3.5 exercise is completed. 3.3 exercise is completed. This is 50 degree. This is 90 degree. Okay, up to this one, 3.3 exercise is completed.